Hello everyone, we are studying the mechanisms of organic reactions. So the next term is nucleophilicity and basicity. Yes, first we will see what is nucleophile. So the nucleophile is any species, it is having unshared electron pair. Yes, consider this OH negative ion. This oxygen consists of three unshared electron pairs. Okay, so it is considered as a nucleophile. Okay, and this unshared electron pair can be utilized to react with the electron deficient species. Let's take another example. Suppose say cyanide ion. Same in this case also, the unshared electron pair is present. Yes, ammonia, nitrogen. With the nitrogen, unshared electron pair is present. Or R, NH2, primary amines, all these are the examples of nucleophile, okay, etc. Yes, so these are the examples of nucleophiles, and these nucleophiles are having unshared electron pairs. Yes, and these can react with, or these unshared electron pairs, they can utilize for the reaction with electron deficient species, okay, and all this nucleophiles are also Lewis bases. Okay, so their relative strength of these bases is expressed in terms of basicity. Yes, so the basicity is measured in terms of Kb or pKb. Okay, we'll write the general reaction for these bases first. That will be, consider any base as BOH. Dissociation of this base can be written as B plus and OH negative ion. Yes, this negative sign should be on oxygen. Yes, so the Kb for this reaction can be written as Kb will be equal to, this will be the product of the concentration of products, so it will be concentration of B plus multiplied by concentration of OH negative ion divided by concentration of this reactant. Okay, so by this formula we can calculate Kb. Yes, and pKb is calculated from Kb, that is pKb is negative log to the base 10 of Kb. Okay, so by this formula we can find out Kb and pKb. Okay, so the smaller values of this pKb means the stronger the base is stronger. For example, take NH3 is having pKb value for NH3 is 4.7, and that of the pyridine 8.8. Okay, so in this case this NH3 is stronger base than the pyridine because it is having the less value. Yes, clear. And this basicity indicates the extent to which the base accepts proton. Yes, and it is thermodynamic term, and it affects the position of acid base equilibrium. And if the basicity is more, the acid base equilibrium will be more towards the right hand side. Yes, clear. Next we will see the term, what is nucleophilicity. Yes, so the nucleophilicity is the measure of how fast this Lewis bases forms a bond with a suitable substrate and displace the leaving groups. Therefore this nucleophilicity is a kinetic term and it affects the rate of reaction. Yes, basicity is the thermodynamic term and nucleophilicity is the kinetic term. Okay, so this nucleophilicity is, or it can be determined by measuring the rates at which the different nucleophiles react with the substrate, and it is relative to the standard nucleophile like methanol. Yes, first we will see the formula for this nucleophilicity. It is represented as NP. Yes, now we will consider the standard nucleophile as a methanol. So this will be the ratio of K nucleophile with the K of methanol. Okay, so by this formula we can find out the nucleophilicity. Yes, and anions are having higher nucleophilicity and that are the better nucleophiles than the neutral molecule. Yes, let's take example. Suppose any alkoxy ions and consider a neutral molecule such as ROH. This is the neutral molecule and this is any anion. Yes, so these anions are having higher nucleophilicity and these are the better nucleophiles. Okay, so the NP value for this will be 10 raised to 4 and for the ROH NP value will be equal to 1. Okay, so in this case anions are having higher nucleophilicity. Yes, and suppose consider if two nucleophiles have the same nucleophilic atom. Let's consider one example. Once again take this example. And suppose say RCOO- I. Okay, so in this case the two nucleophiles having the same nucleophilic atom, that is oxygen. Yes, so then the nucleophilicity increases with increase in the basicity. Yes, here this is the strong base and this is the weak base. Okay, so in this case the nucleophilicity of this RO is greater than this. Yes, clear? So this holds good when comparing the atoms in the same row in the periodic table. So consider the example for OH negative ions are more basic and more nucleophilic than fluorine ions. Yes, and also ammonia is more basic and more nucleophilic than H2O. Yes, and this doesn't hold good while comparing the atoms down the group. Yes, here we have compared the atoms in a same row. Now we'll consider the atoms in a same row. Down the group. Yes, so here iodine ions are less basic but more nucleophilic than the fluorine ions. Yes, and this fluorine ions being smaller in size and is solvated by H2O molecules more than the iodine ions, and therefore this fluorine ions cannot come out of this cage and these are acting as a nucleophile. Yes, so that is why it is weaker nucleophile than iodine. Okay, and for the same reason this OH is more basic but these are less nucleophilic than SH. Yes, clear? So here we have compared the nucleophilicity and basicity. Clear?